Hallelujah, hallelujah. What another beautiful and awesome, blessed day today to always be in the presence of the Lord. Another day to always give him the thanks right now. Another day to always give him the praise right now. Another day to always give him the glory right now in the house of the Lord. And I'm so excited today, my brothers and sisters, just to be in his presence. I'm so excited right now today to share his word with all his sons and daughters right now, because I believe this word and I believe that this anointing message is for somebody today. I don't know who, but God is about to talk to somebody. God is about to heal somebody. God is about to prepare somebody for something that they've been asking God to help them get out of. So this word is for you. And I need y'all to pay attention, because God is about to speak to somebody. God is about to show up. God is about to show out. And by God is about to show up and show out, I need all my sisters, I need all my brothers right now today in the house of the Lord. I need y'all guys to open up your mouth and give him a shout out of praise, because praise is an everyday thing. It's not an on and off switch thing, and it's not a seasonal thing. It is an everyday thing, because we serve an awesome and amazing God who is still on the throne and who is still performing miracles and wonders each and every day in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Before we get into this word, let us bow our heads and let us pray. Heavenly Father God, we come before you peacefully and humbly right now today in the mighty name of Jesus. We thank you for this beautiful, blessed day. We thank you for this opportunity. We thank you, Father God, for this chance of a lifetime. We thank you, Heavenly Father God, that you allow myself, my sisters, and my brothers to come together today, Father God, as one in your house, to fellowship together, to praise your name together, to worship your name together, to give you the glory together, Father God, and also to magnify and exalt your holy name together. Father God, there's no place that we're ready to be at right now today, Jesus, but in your house, seeking you and praising you and giving you the glory, God, what you deserve, God. Father God, this is your house, the house that you built on solid ground, the house that you built on solid foundation, the house that cannot be moved and it cannot fail and it cannot be destroyed by nothing whatsoever, Father God. Oh, Father God, this is your house. Your house is the house of prayer and praise. Right now, God, we are praying in your house, God, to give you the thanks, praise, and glory. Father God, we about to have worship in your house. We about to have fellowship in your house. We about to have service in your house, God. And God, we know that you about to show up and show out in your house right now today. God, we know that you about to speak to somebody today in your house, God. Father God, somebody going to get their life over and want to be connected to you today, God. Father God, somebody's going to cry for help to you today, God, in your house, God. Father God, I see a miracle. I see blessings about to come down in your house today, God. Oh, Father God, I see the angels right now, Father God, rejoicing in your house with us today, God. Oh, Father God, your word also tell us, it's Matthew 18, verse 19. Where two or more gather in your name, hallelujah, then you are in the midst of things. So, Father God, I know that you're in the midst of our homes right now. I know that you're in the midst of our television sets right now. I know that you're in the midst of our telephones right now, our laptops right now, our desktops right now, our iPad right now, or whatever gadget we have, or whatever gadget we use, God. God, we know that you're in the midst. Father God, we know, Father God, that you're finna do some miracles in this place right now today, God. Father God, we know that you about to touch somebody right now. Father God, we know that you about to speak to somebody right now. Father God, we know that you about to heal somebody right now. Oh, Father God, that you about to move through your sons, that you about to move through your daughters right now. Oh, Heavenly Father God, I'm asking you to do a new thing through my sisters today. Do a new thing through my brothers today. Do a new thing through me today, God. Father God, allow your spirit to move through this place right now today, God. Father God, I'm asking you, Father God, to place a fresh new anointing on my brother's life right now today. A fresh new anointing on my sister's life right now today. A fresh new anointing on my life right now today, God. Father God, have your angel to watch over and protect us right now today, God. Cover us through your wings right now today, God. Oh, God, we know that you're a healer. We know that you're a provider. God, we know that you're going to make a way out of no way, God. Even though it seemed dark, even though it seemed gloomy, God. But, God, today is the day, God, that we're going to continue to pick up our cross and follow you no matter what. We're going to continue to put our faith and trust in you, Jesus, no matter what. Oh, God, we know that you have not led us this far, God, to fail us or disappoint us. Oh, God, we know, God, that you're working things out behind the scene. Oh, God, we're going to continue to march in our marching band to give you the thanks, praise, and glory in your house right now today. Oh, Father God, I need you to touch my brothers right now. Oh, God, I need you to touch my sisters right now. Oh, God, I need you to do something like you never done before. Holy Spirit, I need you to move in this place. Holy Spirit, I need you to move through my brothers right now. Holy Spirit, I need you to move through my sisters right now. Holy Spirit, I need you to remove the fish scales from my brothers and my sisters' eyes right now so they can see clearly whatever it is that God needs them to see. Holy Spirit, I'm asking you to remove the earplugs from my brothers and my sisters' ears right now today so they can hear Jesus' soft, still voice right now today. Oh, God, we lift these prayers up to you right now today. God, knowing that you're listening to them, knowing that you heard them, God. And God, we're here today to let you know that we are available for praise, that we are available for service, that we are available for the kingdom, that we are available right now today for us to continue to do our Father's will, that we are available for our assignment, that we are available for our mission, that we are available for our task, that we are available, God, what you have called, chosen, and considered us to do, God. And God, we give you the thanks right now. We give you the praise right now. And we give you the glory right now. In Jesus' holy mighty name. And let the church come together to say amen and amen. Because God is good all the time. And all the time. God is good. Amen. Amen. I want to talk about pain right now today. And I believe that someone is going through a lot of pain right now. And I understand the pain that you are going through. I understand the pain that you are facing in this season because I'm still going through some pain. And I know that there's some people that's laughing at you. And you will never thought the person that's laughing at you would do you like that. You'll never thought the person who's deceiving you would do you like that. You'll never thought the person who you thought was your friend would do you like that. You'll never thought your family members would do you like that. You'll never thought that so-called friend would turn his or her back on you like that, even though they was going through something similar, but you was going through and you was there for them, but now you going through it. Now they have the audacity to sit there and laugh at you. You have no room whatsoever to laugh at my brothers. You have no room whatsoever to laugh at my sisters. I know exactly what you are going through. And I know it's difficult. I know it's making you feel uncomfortable. I know you feel like that. I know you feel like that the world is against you. I know that you feel like that the walls is closing in. I know that you feel like every door is just slamming in your face. I know every time you turn right, you don't see nothing. Every time you turn left, you still don't see nothing. And I know that you are questioning God over and over and over again. God, where you at? But one thing I know about our God, God is closer to the brokenhearted. He is real close. And we're going to read from three Bible scriptures today. We're going to read Genesis 30. We're going to read 1 Samuel chapter 1, verse 2. And we're going to finish off at Job 12, verse 4. How dare you laugh at somebody because they're going through some pain. Not too long ago, you was going through some pain too. Not too long ago, you were suffering too. Not too long ago, you was broke. And you were asking people to loan you money. In no good way, you ain't have no job or no income to pay the person back. Now you don't got back on your feet and you got the dash of the laugh at somebody else because they struggling financially. How dare you? How dare you can laugh at somebody because they're going through a health crisis. Not too long ago, you was going through the same thing and you were asking everybody and their mother to pray for you. And now that you don't heal, now the same person going through the same thing, now you got the audacity and run their name through the ground. You got the audacity to talk bad about them. Now you got the audacity to turn your back on them when they was there for you. A lot of you going through a lot of pain in your relationship, in your marriage. Right now, I know how it is to go through something like that. Not too long ago, last year, I went through the same thing. Going through a separation and divorce in my marriage. Here I was ministering to people, trying to help people, going through the same thing I was going through. Here it is, I had a suicide watch on my marriage. I had a suicide watch in my house. And the same people who I thought was going to be there for me were the same people who was laughing at me, downing me out. But they were the same people, they was going through the same thing, and I was there for them. I never criticized them. What they was going through. I was there for them, to lift them up, to cheer for them. But when I was going through it, it was all jokes. It was all laughter. It was all he this and ha ha that. They didn't understand the devastation that I was going through. They didn't understand the hurt and the deceit that I was going through. They didn't understand the betrayal that I was facing. They didn't understand I was wearing a mask on my face. They didn't understand the crying, and I was crying in the inside, but the cry was never shown on the outside. And you had the audacity to laugh at me. And now some of you have the audacity to laugh at my brothers because they're going through it. Some of y'all have the audacity to laugh at my sisters because they're going through it. But when it was your turn, you didn't want nobody to laugh at you. You wanted people to help you. You wanted people to feel sorry for you. He wanted people to pray for you. So the same people who you laughing at now were the same people who was there for you. Now you don't get back right. Now everything is all crystal clear. And you got the audacity to laugh at this brother now because he's going through it. You have the audacity to laugh at this sister right now because she's going through. You didn't laugh when that brother left you and he left you for another woman. You didn't laugh at her when that woman left you to be with another man. It was all good. Now, but you don't understand what my brothers and sisters going through right now. They're going through a hardship right now. And it feels worse than a toothache. It feels worse than a headache. Their blood pressure sky high to the roof. There's nobody there for them. It seems like it's them against the world. I know what you're going through. I know how you feel. It was a time when you was looking out for everybody. Now you don't have it no more to look out for nobody. Now, the same one that you was looking out for, they don't got on their feet. And now they got a dash of laugh at you. Say, look at you, you're broke now. You can't do this, you can't do that. But it wasn't so long ago, they was broke. It was not too long ago, they didn't have money to pay their rent. It was not too long ago, they didn't have money to put gas in their car. It was not too long ago, they didn't have money to put food on their table to provide for their family or their children. It was not too long ago when they ain't have a job. But you went out your way to get that brother and get that sister a job so you can help them out. So now the tables don't turn and you got the reason, you got the audacity to laugh at somebody. Don't laugh at somebody else's pain. Do not, I emphasize this because I take this message so seriously, because I know my brothers right now, I know some of my sisters right now, they're going through some excruciating pain right now, and they think nobody there care for them. They think there's no love for them. But I'm here today to tell you, my brothers, my sisters, if there's nobody care for you when you're going through your pain, Servant Minister FT care for you. If you need prayer, I will pray for you. If you need someone to talk to, I'll talk to you. I even give you my email. It can be you and I. Nobody got to know what we're talking about because I know what you're going through. I know exactly what you're facing. I know the road in front of you, it does not look clear. The storm is heavy right now. It's rough right now. This season right now today, you didn't imagine that you're going to go through this much pain. I understand that. I've been there. I've been in your shoes. So I know exactly what you were going through. So I would never laugh at you because I know it's not funny. I know it's not cute. But I'm talking to the ones who is laughing at someone who's going through some pain. Everybody go through pain. That's part of life. You can't shake it. You can't run away from it. You can't skip from it. You can't hop from it. You're going to go through some pain somehow or somewhere. You're going to go through it. But just don't start laughing at someone because your season of pain is over with and their season of pain just started. Don't try to look down on someone because your pain has ended and their pain just started. Don't try to judge someone because your pain just ended in this season and their pain just started. Don't try to gossip about someone's pain when your pain just ended and their pain just started. Because that's at the end of the day, that's what a lot of y'all doing. You're gossiping and you're whispering about somebody's pain. You putting it all on social media. Like it's a social media problem. Social media don't know that brother. Social media don't know that sister. You supposed to know that brother. You supposed to know that sister. You supposed to be his friend. You supposed to be her friend. You supposed to be his you supposed to be his uncle. You supposed to be the aunt. You supposed to be some type of friend. So how in the world are you gonna turn your back against him and her when they was there for you when you was going through it? You needed them then. You needed everybody and their mother and their father to help you. And what get me with a lot of y'all right now today. When you go through your pain, when you're hurting, when you're suffering, you want everybody to console you. You want everybody to be there with you in every second, every minute of the day. But the moment that God come through and heal you and get you back on your feet, you forget who was there for you. You forget who was consoling you. You forget who was praying for you. You would have think that you would want to return a favor. You would have think, say, you know what? I know what you were going through because I went through it. If there's any way that I can help. But no, you want to laugh. You think it's a joke. You think it's a video game that you can just pick up and just play and just pick at somebody because they're going through something. A lot of people right now, they're on suicidal watch right now because of the pain. A lot of people right now, they can't even eat food right now because of the pain. They're losing weight by the second. They're losing their hair by the second because of the pain. The suffering and the hurt, the disappointment, the deceived, the backtrail, the backstabbing. But y'all don't think y'all was in that same boat too, not too long ago, losing weight, losing your hair, losing your mind. Didn't know if you was coming and going, can't get back and forth to work because you was so much pain. But now you better now. You got that audacity to laugh. Don't laugh at my brothers no more. Don't laugh at my sister no more, because it could be you again. It could be you again, because I don't think some of y'all, you learned your lesson. Don't think because God got you out of it, don't mean that you can go right back into it, because you can. God sees and hears everything. Amen? Amen. So let's read from the first verse. Let's go to Genesis. We're going to go to Genesis 30. And these talking about two sisters. Genesis 30, verse 1. When Rachel saw that she was not bearing Jacob any children, she became jealous of her sister. So she said to Jacob, "Give me children or I die." Do you see the pain that she was going through? Do you see the affliction that she was facing? Here she is married to this man. One sister was having children, which he was married to, married to both sisters. One wife had this, one wife was happy, but the other one wasn't. The other one couldn't have children at all. Leah was having a good time. Look, we both married to the same man. Look, I'm getting pregnant back and forth, and you can't even bear children. Leah didn't understand the pain that Rachel was going through. Leah didn't even understand the difficulties and the disappointment that Rachel was going through. Then she didn't have the audacity to say, "I still want you to be the auntie. I still want you to be at the baby shower." Only thing Leah was worried about, how she was getting pregnant and Rachel wasn't. It was all laughter. It was all fun and games to her. She didn't understand the depth of the pain that Rachel was going through. Rachel couldn't take it. She even told God, said, "God, if you don't give me kids, you may as well take my life." A lot of you right now today, you're going through that type of pain right now. "God, you can't help me," or "God, you can't heal me. God, I need you to get me out of here. God, I need you to take my life." So a lot of people don't understand the depth of the pain what somebody going through. If you have never walked in that brother or that sister's shoes, you don't have no right to laugh. You have no right to pick. You have no right to judge. You have no right to even try to criticize somebody else in their predicament of pain right now. Because it's going to come a time that you're going to go through that same type of pain and how you're going to feel as somebody doing you the same way. You're not going to like it. It's going to make you uneasy. It's going to make you uncomfortable. Amen? Amen. Verse 9. When Leah saw that she had stopped what? Having children. She took her maidservant, Zilpah, and gave her to Jacob as a wife. Leah's servant, Zilpah, bore Jacob a son. Then Leah said, "What good fortune!" So she named him Gad. Leah's servant Zilpah bore Jacob a second son. Then Leah said, "How happy I am! The one will call me happy." So she named him Asher. So even after all of that, the back and the forward and the forward and the backward, when Leah stopped having children, Leah said, "Okay, Jacob, I'm going to give you my maidservant, but I still want you to sleep with her so we can have more children." So Leah was still picking that Rachel, because at this time, Rachel still was not able to bear children. The only thing Leah was worried about, that long as she is happy, long as Jacob was laying with her and making her happy, that was the only thing. But one thing that Leah didn't realize, that Jacob loved Rachel more than he loved Leah. She didn't see that part. She was laughing. Now let's go to verse 21. Sometime later, she gave birth to a daughter and named him Dinah. Then 22. Now he got a powerful thing. Then God remembered Rachel. He listened to her and opened her womb, and she became pregnant and gave birth to a son, and said, "God has taken away my disgrace." She named him Joseph and said, "May the Lord add to me another son." Right now, a lot of you going through some pain right now, and I believe that God has heard your cry. God has remembered you from the depth of your pain, and God is going to bless you with a blessing, my brothers and my sisters, the same way that he did Rachel. And it's going to be more than enough. God remembers Rachel's cry. He remembered the pain and the suffering and the struggle that she went through year after year, season after season. God remembered your cry. God remembered your pain that you have faced year after year, season after season. But look how big and powerful Rachel's blessing was compared to Leah. Rachel had a son named Joseph. Joseph had a son named Jesus, the Almighty King of Kings and Lords of Lords. There's no other name powerful and sweeter than the name of Jesus. Do you see how God can use someone else's pain and take it and turn it to a blessing? The pain that you are going through right now, the pain that you are feeling right now, will not compare to the joy that God is going to bring to you. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Let's go to 1 Samuel. We go to 1 Samuel verses 1 and 2. He had two wives. One was called Hannah and the other one Peninnah. Peninnah had children, but Hannah had none. Here it is, two sisters again. One sister was having children, the other sister wasn't. One sister just kept picking and picking and picking. This kept torturing her over and over again. But now he didn't realize the pain that Hannah was going through. But God knew what Hannah was going through. God knew somehow that he was going to bless Hannah with a double portion. But Hannah didn't even realize what God was doing behind the scene. Hannah didn't realize what God was doing behind the curtain. Hannah didn't realize what God is about to show up and show out in her life. Even though her sister kept picking and ridiculing her over and over again, and with this torturing her, and Hannah went through a lot of pain, just like Rachel went through a lot of pain with her sister Leah. Right now, there's some brothers going back and forth with pain. There's some sisters right now going back and forth with pain. There's some people right now today can't even have children right now, and you got to dance and laugh at that brother and sister because they can't have children. How would you feel if the shoe was on the other foot? There's some brothers and sisters right now today can't even do this, can't even do that. How would you feel if the shoe was on the other foot? How would you feel? How would you feel if you're in that sister's shoe right now today, my sisters? How would you feel right now today, my brothers, if you was in that brother's shoe right now? It won't feel so good. You wouldn't even make it. Some of y'all aren't even strong enough as my brothers and sisters through the pain that they're going through, the affliction right now, the suffering and the struggle. I went through it. I went through it, but it didn't break me. It made me stronger. It made me wiser. It made me a better man. It allowed me to open my eyes and see who was really my friends. It also showed me who was really died for me, who had my back in the midst of my disappointment, in the midst of my suffering, in the midst of my struggle, in the midst of my hardship, in the midst of everything I was going through in my dark time. Amen. 7. This went on year after year. Whenever Hannah went up to the house of the Lord, her rival provoked her until she wept and would not eat. Elkanah, her husband, would say to her, "Hannah, why are you weeping? Why don't you eat? Why are you downhearted? Don't I mean more to you than 10 sons?" Once when they had finished eating and drinking, inshallah, Hannah stood up. Now Eli, the priest, was sitting on the chair by the doorpost of the Lord's temple in bitterness of soul. Hannah wept much and prayed to the Lord, and she made a vow, saying, "O Lord Almighty, if you will only look upon your servant's misery and remember me and not forget your servant, but give her a son, then I will give him to the Lord for all the days of his life, and no razor will ever be used on his head." As she kept on praying to the Lord, Eli observed her mouth. Hannah was praying in her heart. Her lips were moving, but her voice was not heard. Eli thought she was drunk and said to her, "How long will you keep getting drunk and get rid of your wine?" But God ended up blessing Hannah with a double portion. And I believe that God has heard your prayer. I believe that you have prayed to God so hard. You didn't pray from your lips, but you prayed from the depth of your heart. And your prayer has just moved Jesus. And Jesus told me to tell you right now today, get ready. Your prayer has been heard. Justice is coming. There's no way I'm going to continue to put you off anymore. Because he tells us that in Luke 18 verses 1 and 8. Because you've been consistent in your prayer. You've been persistent in your prayer. And you never, your faith never wavered. Not one time. Get ready. God is about to do some amazing things in your life. God is about to show up and show out right now today. You better receive an abundance of overflow of joy in your health, in your marriage, in your finances, in your dreams, in your business, in your ministry, because the pain that you had to go through, and God has heard your prayer from the depth, from the bottom depth of your heart. Amen. Amen. So let's go to Job 12, and we're going to read verse 4. Job 12, verse 4. I hope y'all writing all these Bible verses down, because I want y'all to write them down and go back and read them yourself. The first one was Genesis 30. The second was 1 Samuel 1 and 2. The last one is Job 12, verse 4. "I have become a laughingstock to my friends. Though I call upon God, and he answered, a mere laughingstock though? Righteous and blameless." Do you see how Job was going through some pain? Job was a man who had everything a man could want, everything a man could even think of and dream of. But when God tested him and took what he had to prove a point, Job went through some pain. Friends weren't his friends no more. Even his wife turned her back against him. People started laughing at Job. Now, this is the same man who was looking out for people. The same man who was blessing people. But when he lost everything, people turned their back. People showed their true colors. Everybody's your friend when it's beneficial to them. Everybody's your friend when you're looking out for them. Everybody's your friend and everybody your family members when you got something to give them. But when you ain't got nothing to give them no more, when you're not beneficial to them no more, when you can't look out for them no more, when you can't do this and when you can't do that, that's when the hating started. That's when the picking started. That's when the laughing started. That's when they want to start talking behind your back. That's when they want to start crucifying you because you can't do this, you can't do that. How dare you laugh at somebody that's pain when you could be in that same predicament like Job went through, like Hannah went through, like Rachel went through, like Servant Minister LT went through, like my brother's going through, like my sister's going through. I've got a point to tell somebody right now today, if you don't stop it soon and quicker, you will be next. I don't know who I'm talking to today. I don't know who I'm preaching to today. If you don't stop doing what you're doing, you will be next. Don't think because God looked out for you the first time that you can't go back in that same slump. Because you can go back in that same pit. But when you go back this time, ain't gonna be there won't be nobody there for you to help you. It won't be nobody there to try to console you. It won't be nobody there to try to pray for you. Because look what you did to that brother when he was going through it. Look what you did to that sister when she was going through it. That same brother, that same sister was there for you when you done it. So don't forget where you come from. Remember, help somebody out in pain. Because a lot of people are going through a lot of pain right now. They got a suicide watch over their home, a suicidal watch over their finances, a suicidal watch over their marriage, a suicidal watch over their children, a suicidal watch over their ministry, a suicidal watch over their business because of the pain, because of the hurt. We all gonna go through this. That's part of life. But do not laugh at somebody's pain because that pain can be you and yours can be twice as worse than their brothers and sisters. But if you look at Hannah, if you look at Rachel, you look at Job, all three of them cried out to God. And what God do? God heard their prayer and God blessed them with twice as much. I believe today that God has heard your prayer today, my brothers. I believe today that God has heard your prayer today, my sisters. And the reason why God heard your prayer because you prayed from your heart. You didn't pray from your mouth. You prayed from your heart, from the depth of your heart. In the same way how God blessed Rachel with a double portion, he's going to bless you with a double portion. The same way how God blessed Hannah with a double portion, he's going to bless you with a double portion. The same way how God blessed Job with a double portion, God's going to bless you with a double portion. The point I'm making is, even though that you're going through this pain and you've been seeking Jesus, you're still praising him, you still glorify him, I'm here today to tell you right now today, God told me to tell you, he has heard your prayer, and get ready, you will receive your double portion sooner than later, because Jesus is about to show up and he's about to show out. And if this word is for you, give God some thanks right now and give God some praise right now in the house of the Lord. Can you please pray with me? Lord Jesus, I ask of you to come into our life, to guide us, direct us, use us. I believe right now today in the mighty name of Jesus, by us praying that simple little prayer, that God is already working everything out in our life right now today. And if you ever want to get in contact with me or leave me a comment, my YouTube channel is withers.lt. Always continue to seek him. Always continue to praise him. Always continue to trust him. Always continue to glorify him. Always continue to pick up your cross and follow him. Always continue to use faith over fear. Always pray for your fellow brothers and sisters. It doesn't matter if you know them. It doesn't matter if you've seen their face. Prayer help and prayer changes things. I'm always going to continue to keep y'all in prayer. I just ask y'all guys continue to keep me in prayer and keep me lifted up too. This is Servant Minister LT. I love y'all. Stay blessed. Amen.